What is up, my New World explorers, adventurers, and friends? Today I will give you all the reasons why you will try New World Aeternum. I know many of you watching are saying, but Big Head Kitty, no way I'm gonna play that crap, that game. The subreddits are full of negative stuff, the stream reviews are crazy negative, and my own experience tells me that I won't play. AGS devs have a history of not really listening to us or doing anything about exploits in the game, they don't ban people, but I have news for you. If you're watching this, you will play. Let's get started with the reasons why you will play NWA, New World Aeternum. Reason number one is that you already own the game. Basically, if you own the base game and the DLC, Rise of the Angry Earth, when October drops, you will get all the new content and no extra cost. So when the console is released, you'll get access to all the new features, as well as a mini expansion, the 10-man raid, the solo trials, gear score increased to 700. So, also include our matchmaking for PvP crowd, as well as the free-for-all island PvP zone. We'll see how that works out. I have a feeling it's just going to be a bunch of muskets standing at every possible entrance. But maybe if it's an island, you'll have to swim to it, and you can go to different spots. And hopefully it's got pretty big, so you won't have so many people doing that to you. And for the PvE players, which will be mostly probably coming for console, you get the upgraded main story quest with a better story somatics and voice acting, which they actually did a good job with things like that, the voice acting, the different cutscenes later in the game. They did some for Brimstone Sands. And then, of course, the sound effects and stuff and the graphics are very, very good. So, and if this reason isn't enough for you to give it a try in October, we'll continue on the second reason why you will play New World Aeternum. Okay, so reason number two is mainly for the PvP crowd. So, you know you're going to want to show off your e-penis and curb stomp all the fresh Outpost Rush PvP players that you encounter when they first get the chance to play Outpost Rush. Gonna have a huge advantage on PC already because of the different exploits and animation hacks and things that are easier to pull off if you've already doing things like that. And I bet a lot of you playing or probably are, so I've never really gotten the hang of it and didn't worry about it, so because I figured one day they would fix it. But plus you're already gonna have a chance, you're gonna grind your gear score to 700, so if they fix the issue with the gear scaling and Outpost Rush and PvP, then you're gonna be miles ahead of everybody else. So these guys are going to get their first taste of PvP and you're just going to smash them, absolutely destroy the new players, provided that they fix that gear scaling prior to launch. Know that you will love massacring the new players in Outpost Rush and influence races, so don't bother to deny it. This is the second reason why you'll join us in October when the console release happens for New World Aeternum. This reason kind of moves us into reason number three why you'll play New World Aeternum. You enjoy the playstyle, especially for PvP. A lot of people like the different skill sets, so the simplicity of having three skills for two weapons, and to make combos with them, the option to use different combos of weapons and armor is enjoyable to most people. You like the quick rollout of danger for light players, or maybe the sidestep of medium or the lumbering step of heavy armor. You like being able to use a mage weapon with a melee weapon, or the diversity of bleed builds or different range builds, a lot of the attunements and stuff. So a lot of different things you can do, even though simple yet complicated at the same time. This is the third reason why I'll see you in October. Reason number four is that there will be an influx of new players to socialize with, and or in some cases exploit for profit. So especially the gold sellers are going to enjoy this. I mean, maybe some of the big war companies will have some new prey to sell some goods to, so they'll be able to fund their wars and fund their illegal activities maybe. I know not all of them. Most war servers are pretty good, or war companies are pretty decent. There's just a few. Won't mention them. Now they'll probably back, maybe lock out the legacy servers and include many fresh start servers. So that being said, if you're on a legacy server, you're still gonna eventually get in the crossplay Outpost Rush like I mentioned before, so that's really gonna be awesome. You're gonna curb stomp the crap out of those guys. But so many people are gonna do a fresh start server, including myself, to experience the revamped the main story quest, the early game again, because it was fun. Early game of New World has always been enjoyable, offered close to 100 hours of gameplay. If the glitches and exploits are fixed from the current version that were there whenever New World originally launched, I think we're going to have thousands and thousands of new and returning players. So if it's true that a million people actually bought the game, which I think a lot of that were, there, some of those were Steam shares and stuff, so maybe we'll say there were 800,000 actual players. I mean, even if a couple percent come back, you're getting 8,000 to 10,000 players, maybe 20,000 players return, so it'd be pretty nice if that happens. So you should have fun for a while. So let me know in the comments if I'll see you on a fresh start server come October when New World Aeternum launches. Alright, to the fifth and the final reason why you'll play New World Aeternum, is that you simply have nothing better to do. You're addicted to it like a crack squirrel. Maybe a warlogger or always in search of the perfect gear sets and optimal playstyles. You'll have a gear score increase that you want to max out as quickly as possible, as well as new best in slot gear sets to craft or PvP to acquire. you still play, then you're mainly doing these things, and PvP is the mode you enjoy the most. There will be a PvP island free-for-all zone and matchmaking, so it'll keep you occupied for a good while. Depending on how these things are implemented, you may very well enjoy them and stay longer than you would have ever thought. And if they don't have as many exploits and maybe they ban some people and stuff that mess up, I think you'll stay around a long time because you're still here now. So that means you're probably still going to stick around regardless of how much you hate it or dislike it. This is a second chance to do right by the customers for Amazon Game Studios. Hope the launch of New World Aeternum goes more smoothly than the original New World launch and the bugs will be fixed quickly. I expect that they will ban people for exploits more aggressively, as it will have a greater impact on console players than it does on PC players for sure. And being that console is the future of New World, those PC players are kind of along for the ride at this point. I hope it works out, as the game itself is very nice in its core and the graphics and sound aspects and the limited playstyle, the skills and stuff, so it's pretty cool. I hope to see many of you come October 15th when New World Aeternum launches on console. Thanks for watching and enjoy the time from now until October. There's plenty that you can still do in the meantime to be ready for the launch. Gold to be stored, skills to be honed. See you in Aeternum. Let me know if you're going to play. And after this, I'll close out the video with the trailer for New World Aeternum that drops October 15th for PlayStation, Xbox, PC as well. So hope to see you then. Let you enjoy the trailer.
Through the endless tides of time, they've come to these mythical shores seeking mastery over death itself. A cruel and beautiful paradise. Where primal forces clash over the island's deepest secrets. Where ancient mysteries awaken. Is Aeternum.